Hello guys, welcome to Sickness Thick. Today we are going to study about registered organization of 8086. If you like this video, press the like button, and for more videos, subscribe the channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. First of all, we can check what is a register. Register is a very small amount of fast memory that is built in the CPU in order to speed up the operation. Register is very fast and efficient than other memories like RAM, ROM and external memory. That is about the register. We can check the register organization in 8086. 8086 consists of two type of registers. First one is general purpose register. We can just call it as GPRS. And second is special purpose registers. We can call it as SPRS. These two registers are 16-bit registers. Where general purpose registers can work as both 8-bit and 16-bit registers. GPRS can temporarily hold the data and variables and intermediate result. These are the main functions of GPRS. It can temporarily hold the data, variables and the intermediate result. Intermediate result means the results after the ALU operations. Then GPRS can be used as counters and can store the offset address for certain addressing modes. It can be used as counters and can store the offset address for certain addressing modes. Then second is SPRS. They are used as segment registers, pointers and index registers. SPRS can store the offset address for the particular addressing mode. It can store the offset address for the particular addressing modes. Okay. Then mainly we can divide the registers into four. First one is general data register. Second is the pointers and index registers. Then third is the segment register. Fourth is the flag register. We can look into the figure of the registers. Okay. This is the figure of registers of 8086. The general data register, pointers and index register and flag registers are in the execution unit. And segment register is in the bus interface unit. Okay, this general data register consists of AX, BX, CX and DS. Here AX can be divided into AH and AL. That is, AH means higher and AL means lower. This AH and AL is 8, each are 8 bits, while AX is a 16 bit. Same in case of BX, CX and DX. They are 16 bit registers and here BH and BL are 8 bits, CH and CL 8 bit, DH and DL are 8 bits. Then the pointers and index registers. There are two pointers, that is SP and BP, stack pointer and a base pointer. Then index register, that is source index and destination index. Source index SI, destination DI. In case of segment registers, it is known as CS, code segment, DS, data segment, SS, stack segment, ES, extra segment. Okay. Then flag register, we can explain the details later. Okay. Then first one, general data register. There are AX, BX, DX, CX and DX. They are 16-bit general purpose registers in 8086. First, AX. AX is a 16-bit accumulator. It is a 16-bit accumulator. It can store the result of ALU operation. It is used to store the result of ALU operation. Then, BX. BX store the offset values in case of addressing mode. It store the offset values in case of addressing mode. Then CX. CX is used as the default counter in case of string and loop instruction. It is used as the default counter in case of string and loop instruction. Then the last one in the General Data Register, that is DX. It is often used as a destination register to store the result. It is used as a destination register to store the result. Okay. Second one is the pointers and index registers. Pointers. Pointers contain offset within the particular segment. Pointers contain offset within the particular segment. Then, there are three types of pointers, that are instruction pointer, base pointer and stack pointer. Instruction pointer, base pointer and stack pointer. They are usually contain offset within the code and the stackment segments. Then, the index registers. Index registers are two, that is source index register SI and destination index register DI. It is used as a general purpose registers, also used to store the offset values in case of certain addressing modes. Also used to store the offset values in case of certain addressing modes. The index registers are used for string manipulations also. It is used for string manipulations also. Then the third one is segment register. Segment register has a memory space of 1 megabyte and is divided into 16 logical segments. Each segment contains 64 kilobyte memory. Mainly, the segment registers are divided into 4, that is first one code segment, CS, data segment, DS, third one extra segment, DS, and fourth one stack segment, SS. First one, CS, that is code segment. It is used to store the executable program. CS is used to store the executable program. Then DS and ES, that is data segment and extra segment. It is used to store the data. Then SS, that is stack segment. It is store the stack data. Then segment register. Segment register is a 16-bit base addresses. It is 16-bit base addresses. It can contain 16-bit base addresses. Then the CS, DS, SS, and ES registers contain the segment addresses for the code, data, stack and extra segments of the memory. Once more I will say, the CS, DS, SS and ES contain the segment addresses for the code, data, stack and extra segments for the memory. All these segments are logical segments and they may or may not be physically separated. They can be physically separated or cannot be separated. Okay. Then the fourth one is flag segment, flag register. Flag register contents indicate the result of computation in the ALU. It indicate the result of computation in the ALU and also contains some flag bit to control the CPU operation. It also contains a flag bit to control the CPU operation. It is a 16-bit register. We can check with the diagram. Okay. This is the flag register. Here we can see it has 16. It is a 16-bit. And here we can check how many are unused. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 are unused. Okay. And 7 flags are unused. And other 9 flags, that is overflow flag, direction flag, interrupt enable flag, wrap flag, sign flag, zero flag, auxiliary carry flag, parity flag, carry flag. These are the used flags. Again, this used flag are used in 9 flags is divided into 2, that is 6 flag and 3 flag. The six flag are known as status or conditional flags, and three flag are known control flags. Control flags are direction flag, interrupt flag, trap flag. Direction flag, that can be represented as D. Interrupt enable flag, that can be represented as I, and trap flag can be represented as T. Other six flags of the nine flag are the status or conditional flag, which shows the condition or the status of after the ALE operation. That is overflow flag, sign flag, zero flag, auxiliary carry flag, parity flag, carry flag. These are about the flag register. Then in the coming video, I will give you more explanation of the flag register with each of these flags. Okay. I hope you like this video. This all for this today's video. Thank you.